Hi, I'm Rick from Raptor Blasting Systems, and today I want to show you the RB3630 Slurry Wet Blast Cabinet. These cabinets are really built for finishing products, like if you're doing a refurb on a motorcycle engine, aluminum cases, those types of products. This cabinet works really good for finishing that and giving it an OEM finish and making it look like a brand new product. As opposed to dry blast, it really kind of seals the surface and gives it a nice sheen and makes it look like it's a new product. The name 3630 is in reference to its size. So this cabinet is 36 inches wide by 30 inches deep by about 36 inches tall. So the interior portion will hold a pretty good size part. The way that these cabinets work is you fill the sump up about 3/4 full with a combination of media and water. Typically we like to put a fine glass bead mixed with some baking soda in this, and we seem to get really good results with that. So the way that it works is if you look on the other side of the cabinet, there's three ports. You have a drain port that can completely drain the sump. You have a second port to where you fill the media to, and then the rest of the sump is filled with water. So that mix sits in the bottom of the cabinet, and as you're blasting, there's a slurry pump inside the sump that is pulling the media and water mix up to the gun, and it's introducing air at the nozzle, which then accelerates the media and gets you your blasting force. So all you need to do to hook this cabinet up is basically hook air to the air regulator. The air regulator passes the air on into the gun. Fill it with water and media. Put water for the rinse hose on the back. We do have a closed loop system for that. We'll talk about that here in a few minutes. And plug the light box in a 110 outlet to turn the light box on and turn the wiper on. For visibility in the cabinet, what we've done is we put a wiper motor and a wiper on the inside of the window. And in addition, you have a water control knob that can get water to the window to run a little bit of water down the window as you're wiping it. And that clears out the cabinet for visibility. This is a stainless steel version of this cabinet. We also have a steel version that's a little less expensive, but I really like the stainless steel version. You can never rust, never have any issues with this cabinet. All of these cabinets, all Raptor Blaster cabinets, are all 100% laser cut and hand seam welded. So there is no leaking, nothing can escape the cabinet. And all of them are very thick gauge steel. This is a 12 gauge steel cabinet. The doors are double paneled so they can never warp, meaning there's an interior panel on the door that is welded to the door, that's bent and welded to the door, so the outer portion can never warp. In addition, to keep a tight seal at all times, we have our latch system where you have an adjustable latch that moves in and out, and as the door wears or the handle wears a little bit or the latch plate wears, you can move it and adjust it to keep the door sealed tight. As you can see, inside the cabinet we have a very ergonomic, it's a nice, comfortable gun. Your pump that's down into the media in the slurry mix is pumping the slurry mix up to the gun by one line, and you're introducing air when you step on the foot pedal on the other line that accelerates the media, and that's where you get the blasting effect. Also inside the cabinet is a rinse off gun for when you're done, you know, blasting the product, you can rinse it off inside the cabinet as well. So the three things you need to get this cabinet running is 1, air to the air inlet, 2, plug the 110 cord of the light box into a wall socket, and 3, hook a hose for your fresh water rinse on the back of the cabinet with the water inlet. Now, if you don't have access to a hose spigot or a hose, or have any water in your shop, or don't want water in your shop, the accessory you could use is the closed loop system. The way the closed loop system works is it has a pneumatic driven pump on it. You fill the tank with water. When you pull the trigger on the rinse nozzle, you're going to draw water from the tank into the cabinet. When the cabinet gets over full, over the overflow, it's going to drain out of the overflow right back into the paper bed filter. As you can see here, we have a stainless steel tray that sets on top of the tank, and then you'll put the paper over the tank, and basically the water will drop right into the paper bed filter, drain the water, it will screen any of the particulates or dirt, grime, anything out of the water, and refill the tank with fresh water. So you're recirculating your rinse water from within the cabinet at all times. So that's the RB3630 Slurry Blast Cabinet.